Good morning, children. We have already started with this chapter, Transport in Plants. Let us proceed further. Today, we'll deal with the topic transpiration. So, what is transpiration? Transpiration is the loss of water in the form of water vapors from the aerial parts of the plant. Yes, aerial means it includes leaf and stem. So, understood? So, what is transpiration? It is the loss of water in the form of water vapors from the aerial parts of the plant. Now, let us discuss what are the various factors which affect the rate of transpiration. There are four factors given in your chapter. So, light, temperature, wind and humidity. Let us study in detail. How sunlight is affecting the rate of transpiration. See, during the daytime, when the sun rises and there is sunlight, the stomata usually opens. Right? It opens for the exchange of the respiratory gases to carry out the process of photosynthesis. But what happens, the water also gets a chance to escape from the stomata in the form of water vapors by a process known as transpiration. But during night time, there is no sunlight, the stomata closes, so the transpiration also stops. The second factor is temperature. Temperature is directly proportional to transpiration. If the temperature is high, the rate of transpiration is high. If the temperature is low, the rate of transpiration is also low. And the third factor is wind. So, how wind is affecting the rate of transpiration? See, my dear children, you all of you know that on leaf, there are small, tiny pores called stomata. Right? So, what happens? The water is coming out through stomata in the form of water vapors by process known as transpiration. So, this area near the leaf, it becomes saturated, it becomes wet. So, when the wind starts blowing, so what is wind? Wind is when the air starts blowing. When the wind starts blowing, it takes away these water vapors. And as a result, what happens? This area around the leaf, it becomes dry. So, it has to be wet. So, the leaf, they do lots of transpiration. So, this is how the wind is responsible for the rate of transpiration. When the wind blows, the rate of transpiration is high because it is taking away all the water vapors which has gathered round the leaf. And the last factor is humidity. So, what is humidity? Humidity means the amount of water vapor in the air. So, when the air is already humid, when the air is already having lots of moisture, so it directs the plants not to do transpiration because the air cannot hold any more moisture. So, when the air is humid, the rate of transpiration decreases. Now, let me ask you one thing. Ki on a foggy day, does the transpiration is fast or the transpiration is slow? See, when a day is foggy, already the air is having lots of moisture. So, on a foggy day, the rate of transpiration decreases. I hope you have understood all these four factors, how they are affecting the rate of transpiration. Let's move further. Now, we need to discuss what is the significance of transpiration in plants. See, transpiration plays a very important role in the plant. Number one, it's because of transpiration, a suction force is created inside the plant. Aapko pata hai ki jab hume pyaas lagti, we rush to kitchen and we drink water. So, likewise, when the plants are showing transpiration, when the trees are showing transpiration, what happens on the upper part of the plant body? A suction force is created, which directs the roots to absorb what? Water. To absorb water. So, how this water molecule is pushed upwards? What happens? You all of you know that how does a vacuum cleaner works? Vacuum cleaner, hum jaise on karte, bahut hi तेज हवा निकलती है वो दूर से डस्ट पार्टिकल को सक कर लेती है तो लाइकवाइज बिकॉज ऑफ ट्रांसपिरेशन अ सक्शन फोर्स इज क्रिएटेड ऑन द अपर पार्ट ऑफ द प्लांट बॉडी सो दिस सक्शन फोर्स इज सो स्ट्रांग इनफ टू पुल द वाटर मॉलिक्यूल हाउ दिस वाटर मॉलिक्यूल इज पुल्ड अपवर्ड्स यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स दे शो अ कोहेसिव प्रॉपर्टी मींस वन वाटर मॉलिक्यूल इज अटैच्ड विद अनदर एंड अनदर विद इट एक्स एंड सो ऑन So, when one water molecule is pulled up in this way, the whole chain of the water molecules pulls up. So, we can say it is only because of transpiration the roots are able to absorb the water and minerals from the soil. And number two is, it gives a cooling effect to the the leaves of the plant. Yes, it's only because of transpiration. The trees, the plants remain cool. You must have observed that on a hot summer day, the upper layer of the leaves, they are very active. They are very fresh, right? How they remain fresh? It's only because of transpiration. So, see, when the water is getting lost from the leaves, what happens? How this water changes in the water vapor? On a hot summer day, what happens? The temperature of the leaf rises. So when the water is moving out from the stomata, it absorbs that heat of the leaf. It absorbs the latent heat of the leaf and comes out. So in this way, it is providing a cooling effect to the leaf. This is how the transpiration plays a very significant role in the plant body. Number one, I repeat, it's only because of transpiration the roots are able to absorb the water and minerals from the soil. And number two, it provides a cooling effect to the leaves of the plant. Yes, my dear children, I've already discussed with you the first part of this chapter. And after this video, I'll be flashing an assignment based on this chapter. I hope you will be able to do it. And in my next class, I'll discuss the answers of that particular assignment. Thank you so much.